Now we move on to our second bout of the evening. This bout is sponsored by Recovery Club Newry and takes place as a catch weight of £130. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, this lady is a grappler representing Fantom MMA, Raquel Gonzalez Garcia!
Just want to jump in to say we saw it after the fight between Declan Ryan and Paul Fitzgerald there. Declan Ryan seemingly apologising to Paul as if that he had overreacted in his post-fight celebration there. So the heat of the moment, of course, you can be influenced by stuff like that, and at least he immediately realised the situation, and fair play to him.
This lady is a mixed martial artist representing SVG Charlestown, Sarah Elliot Sheridan!
While you were gone there, Paul, just to say, I noticed it anyway, the two lads seemingly talking out whatever had happened there at the end of the round. Obviously, there's tensions are flaring, emotions are running very high. I'm glad that he realised he shouldn't have acted that way immediately after the fight, as soon as he did realise and got to right the wrong in the cage, as opposed to later on when he realised something was up. So
yeah, a bit of sportsmanship, it's good to see. Well done to both guys, because it was an absolutely cracking fight while it did last, and I look forward to seeing both of them fight again. They both look like very accomplished strikers, both eager to stand in the pocket and trade, which is always exciting to watch. This next bout is going to look really good. Both of these ladies are pretty good, confident grapplers. Sarah Elliott Sheridan, of course, was the first ever women's championship in the IMAF. Yes, she won it after only a year of training. She's a very highly touted prospect, fighting under old Roddy. And she's got her hands full here with a good jiu-jitsu-based opponent.
Yeah, Leah McCord has told me about her in the past when Leah was up doing a lot with Owen Roddy and SVG Charlestown. They think very highly of her in the gym.
They're straight into grappling from here. It's a battle to see who can get that top position. Garcia working hard to try and land some knees, gives up her balance. The threat of possibly a guillotine on the way down. Doesn't look to have it too secure though. Sheridan should be okay here to pop her head out. The hands are not connected.
I'd imagine that last little second just before the guillotine grip leaves and the person postures up is a very demoralising situation, but a great omoplata attempt as well, just to try and recover for the sweep.
Absolutely. Well, Garcia is she has one win so far on her record by submission, chasing another one here.
Wow, that foot position of the armbar is what maybe prevented Raquel from getting a tighter bite on it. It was in a weird position against Sarah's face. But in terms of her guard, in terms of how she's going, she looks very good. Sarah looking for a back here. It seems like one of the arms was trapped.
Both arms working there. That second hook now, Andrew. She's got the two hooks. Dangerous position now. Garcia needs to work her way out of here.
Very underlooked in MMA a lot of the times, but Sarah's doing very well here. She's tracking the back. You know, she's committed to staying on the back as opposed to falling out. Raquel has had to work very hard to get Sarah back down there.
Absolutely. And there's the arm. The arm bar is tight. She seems to have lost the grip on it now. And it's a scramble now to see who can get it back to a dominant position. Both girls really pushing the pace in the grappling here.
That right arm seems to be close to the throat there. This is a frantic pace.
Absolutely.
Keep this up for all three rounds.
Keep this up, yeah. Garcia, you're going to drive the hips in, extend that single leg. Runs the pipe, gets her to the floor. Sheridan now needs to scramble to get out of this position. Her legs are pinned. Garcia working hard for this pass. Now she's stuck into the half guard.
Half guard is such I know that we both come from the world of jiu-jitsu. It's not the best position in Brazilian jiu-jitsu, but for MMA as a position to be able to land your strikes and make it very hard for the other person to react. This could be an arm bar.
Could be in danger right at the end of the round. She seems to be okay again. And there's the end of round one. A whirlwind of grappling, aggression, positional battling from both ladies. And as you said, it'll be interesting to see if they can maintain this for all three rounds, because it's been pretty frenetic pace so far.
It's a big pace. Now, just for anybody watching at home, Raquel's coach just instructed her to sit down as opposed to her choosing to sit down out of fatigue. So maybe she feels better here in the recovery period in between rounds. But if we talked about the pace of the first round there, would be very shocked if that pace is able to be kept up for all three rounds straight.
Yeah, from both ladies, it was pretty aggressive stuff. Both just scrambling hard throughout the entirety of the round, looking for that dominant position. And it seemed to sway back and forth as the round went on. Here we go, guys, ready for round two. Both ladies back on their feet, ready to step into the action. Heavy leg kick from Sheridan. And Garcia going full Khabib here, driving for that takedown again. Switching to the single. Good defense from Elliot Sheridan. Lovely hip throw. Sheridan into the top position and into the mount. Garcia committed a lot of energy to that takedown attempt, Andrew, and she's on her back now in a really bad spot.
Keep those feet on the inside. Watch your arms, Sarah. Yeah, you walk your hands up. Walk the right hand up. Walk on
up. Let's walk back down.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, we can't see the hand positioning from here. It seems like Sarah's closer to mounting up now, yes. Strikes.
Heavy shots from the top, and now she has the back.
Great advice from Owen Roddy there about sitting back in that situation. It seemed like she was close to losing that top position for a second, even though she had the back.
She was very high, and I don't think she has an underhook either, so
I think she's going to transition to an armbar here if she feels it's going. Raquel is turning the corner very nicely.
That arm is still trapped inside, and it could be in a lot of danger. And she's extending the elbow may just be slipping out.
Yeah, just about gone. I think that's such a hard position to try and finish that from when you're so close to the cage. The cage is influencing your ability to be able to spin or put an angle, put the person out.
Yeah, there's a bit of fatigue setting in with both fighters, but that's no surprise after the pace we've just seen. High pressure style again from Garcia. Every chance she gets, she's making life uncomfortable for Elliot Sheridan, not allowing her to get a foothold in the fight. Ooh, big knees from Elliot Sheridan from the cage.
I hear it's the first thing to teach you when you walk into Owen Roddy's gym. How to throw knees like Owen Roddy.
Not surprised at all. One of the greatest to ever do it out of these parts. Trying to get herself back, but to her feet, not accept the position.
Really nice recovery, a very underutilized technique in my opinion in MMA. Sarah used her right foot to get in behind the calf of Raquel, use her foot to engage and keep it, like it's known as a short hook in the Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu world, I think, or a sneaky hook or something. It's a very, very effective way to stop your opponent from being able to pass you straight away and give you the chance. She bumped that into a side control position, but used it straight away to recover, get the leg and knee back in. Really good reactive grappling there from Sarah Elliott Sheridan.
Yeah, it's been impressive from both sides. Two quite different styles of grappling. You can see Garcia sitting on that floor again, breathing heavy. She's pushing a high pace. Can she do it for one more round?
We just got the lights dimmed here, Paul. Did you notice that? The house lights are off now.
Things are getting serious.
Party mode is starting here. Regular broadcaster, regular viewers will know Damien Rooney fired in horrific fashion from cage management duties, taking over this time. Martine Zambella, Shea Cleland, keeping a great job, locking the door.
Martine, of course, was meant to be fighting the main event, wasn't he?
He was. Unfortunately, fell through.
Neither of these girls seems willing to take a back step. Both coming out aggressive, but now Elliot Sheridan's on her back, against the cage. Is she going to give up her back on the turn? Garcia's looking for it, and she may have it. Two hooks, belly down. Sheridan turning on her side, but she needs to get into a better position from here. She's eating shots. Referee Gary Lyons taking a close look at the action.
I think he was actually warning her there about a shot in the back of the head. One or two of them shots seem to go.
Yeah, as the fighter is turning in that bottom position, it happens a lot.
It's a huge benefit for a fighter at an amateur level when they're in front of their own corner in a dominant position. And the counter side to that on Sarah can really hear at this point is Raquel's coach.
Yeah, that's the pressure of the situation.
Oh,
Garcia could be losing the back. Sheridan turns in it. She's back inside in a guard. Is she in danger of getting armbarred on the way out?
No, I think
she looks like she's okay. I think that elbow is clear. The hip line. Would she step back over the head?
Yeah, this is just going to create another scramble, I think, as soon as the elbow frees.
And these ladies have been non-stop scrambling for this fight so far.
Let's go, Raquel. Let's go. You need to walk.
There's a good chance Elliot Sheridan might need to do something very impressive to put a mark on this third round if she wants to get the victory. Because she's been fighting off this pressure for some time now. She's back to her feet. Can she stay there? Look how quickly Garcia turns that pressure back up again.
Yeah, Garcia had a really interesting clamp there on both of Sarah's forearms, even though there wasn't any immediate danger of the armbar. Really interesting how the first two rounds were scored. What the judges are looking for.
Yeah.
I always say it, I'm happy that I'm doing this job as opposed to the judging job.
Having done both jobs, I can tell you right now that this one is a lot easier, a lot more enjoyable.
Here we go. We can see a finishing sequence here. It's on there.
A late finish here from Elliot Sheridan. That's under the chin. She has one hook, but when you're that deep under the chin, sometimes you can still get this finish. But she slipped off to the side. Garcia's defended it well. Standing battle.
Yeah, in terms of how things are scored, my good friend Sean Sheehan often tries to keep me up to date. I don't know if we're on the new criteria here or the old criteria, but in terms of like any sort of positional grappling that was close to standing the fight there, you'd have to give that little sequence in Sarah's favour. She had one arm under, she forced Raquel into a defensive position and to defend the choke significantly. We'll see how it goes.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, this fight goes to a decision. All three judges score this bout 29-28 to your winner, fighting out of the red corner, Sarah.